Have you ever wondered why it seems so hard to change and get started in a new direction? Say, change a job, start a new business, get out of a negative relationship, or commit to a new relationship, or even decide to get married? How about starting a new diet or exercise, or saving money, or reducing your monthly spending, or even to start budgeting or setting goals, or even to stop a behavior that is not serving you well, like excessive drinking or gaming or TV time? It's the comfort zone that's a culprit, the reason, the main offender. On a light touch, imagine you are in a court of law, or let's say the court of Judge Judy, and you are charged with the offense of resistance to change, with an alternative charge of refusal to step up and pursue your dreams. And the judge says, how do you plead? You might rightfully plead not guilty, Your Honor. And you could as well point to Mr. Comfort Zone as the guilty one who has made you do it. It's Mr. Comfort Zone. But on a serious note, some people do end up in trouble with the law because of the inability to change. Think of a common habit like drunk driving. Once it becomes a habit and enters the comfort zone, it becomes difficult to change. Initially, it will cause minor offenses like driving under the influence. But with time, it may lead to more serious problems, like causing injury to someone or the self because of drunk driving. As those in the American lobby group called MAD, or Mothers Against Drunk Driving, have found out, it's difficult to shift people from such behavior once it fixates in the comfort zone. But of course, it's doable, and that's why they continue to fight to help people get out of their comfort zone and solve that kind of problem. Because human beings are creatures of habit, we prefer to operate in our comfort zone. But in order to succeed in life, career, or business, we need to be open to entering unfamiliar and uncomfortable territory. That is the only way to pivot our lives to where we want to go and to push forward to a new vision. Happiness comes from the ongoing pursuit of a worthy goal. If you're not pursuing a worthy goal, you will feel that something is missing in your life. If you want to achieve extraordinary results, you cannot stay in your comfort zone. You need to get out of that comfort zone, or to expand it so that it can take on more. What is this comfort zone all about? The comfort zone refers to the area of mind space, or mental space if you like, that we operate in, which is familiar, easy, and comfortable. It's a space where you feel safe, and it's not demanding or challenging. It does not require much effort to sustain yourself in that kind of space. So simply put, it's comfortable. But that does not mean that it's positive or negative. No, it's just comfortable. So even if it includes doing negative things that hurt your life, it's comfort based on the familiarity that makes it so hard to change. Staying in your comfort zone implies that you are doing things the same way you have done for years. You are settled in your ways. That's why we like to make New Year resolutions and then find that we cannot seem to follow through beyond a few days or weeks in January. Very few people are able to go to February with their New Year resolutions. Or you attend a training program or watch a motivational video and tell yourself how you will adopt a new action plan based on what you've learned. But in a few days, it's all forgotten and it's a comfort zone again. The comfort of familiar routines. It's not easy to break out of the mental prison of comfort zone. While there may be other reasons why we resist change, research shows that comfort zone is one of the major reasons that the comfort we get from our familiar routines tends to hold us back in making the changes we need to make. We generally like to stay in our comfort space where things are clear, they are predictable, we don't need to learn new things, do new things, or face new fears. Given how hard it is to even change simple things like the route you follow to work or change your morning routine, we need to consciously work to break out of our comfort zone and the limitations it imposes on us. This is the only way to gain the happiness that comes from pursuing our goals in life. Let me propose 5 ways to help you get out of your comfort zone and start pursuing your goals with confidence and determination. First, take bite-sized steps. Everything is easier when taken in small, bite-sized steps. Imagine that you are presented with an unfamiliar food at a friend's dinner party, and your host insists that it's really tasty, and all eyes are on you. But when you look at this food, it doesn't look very appealing to you. It looks somewhat soggy, but you have the curiosity too. How do you go about it? You try it in small bite sizes. That's more bite size. And then another will tell you whether that taste is acceptable to you or not. That's exactly how to get out of your comfort zone, by taking small steps to the direction that you want to go. A mountain climber starts with climbing smaller peaks. And then with time, they can go for the bigger ones, the Mount Kenya, the Mount Kilimanjaro, Mount Everest, and the like. And step by step, you will start feeling the confidence and banish the fear that was holding you back. To start this YouTube channel, I had to get out of my comfort zone. I'd been postponing it for years. And then I decided to take a bite-sized step. Not perfect, but action. And now, 7 months later, I cannot remember what was hindering me. I can't remember what I feared. In that time, I've learned a lot about how YouTube works, and I'm still learning, and I'm prepared to continue learning. And because I'm committed to this journey, I make the time and put the effort to ensure that I create new content every week. Second, accept discomfort as a means to grow. Recognize that discomfort is key to growth. The discomfort of taking away predictability is the only way through to a new direction. Whether it's shifting from single to married, or from employed to owning a business, or from one employer to another, make the discomfort your friend. Because without it, you will not be able to move forward. To continue growing, you must accept the discomfort of change. Without change, you cannot achieve higher order goals. Change is key to achieving extraordinary results. Sometimes, when we fail to take charge of our lives and get out of our comfort zone, we are pushed by others. And now we have to sink or swim. Think of someone who gets fired or retrenched. They are forced into the zone of discomfort, whether they like it or not. And they have to sink or swim. And many times they discover that they are able to swim and move forward. That is called the push factor. Many people only get into a new thing by virtue of being pushed out by others. This could be loss of a job, loss of a major contract or client, or even the threat of divorce or losing an important relationship. It's like how the pandemic forced many people to adopt online tools and resources that they had been resisting for years. But they had to do this for survival. Zoom meetings, YouTube videos, online shopping, and even mobile banking have become familiar territory now. And once they have overcome this discomfort, they have started to enjoy the benefits and may not even want to go back to their old ways ever. Third, affirm the benefits of change. To get the motivation and inspiration that you need to pursue a new direction, you need to identify and affirm the benefits of the new direction. You can start by listing the benefits. What will you gain by taking the new direction? Then move to affirmation, where you apply more feeling in your statement. You affirm the gains. Practice back to the future thinking approach, where you think and explain to yourself how life will be because of taking this new action. Preferably do it in writing. Say, for example, I am now enjoying 1, 2, 3 benefits. Or like say, I'm now enjoying a more loving, happier, energetic, and financially stable life. List the benefits. What will you gain by making the change? Make that affirmation and it will help you in getting out of your comfort zone. To sum it up, my 3 ways to get out of the comfort zone are: first, take bite-sized steps. Second, accept discomfort as a means to grow. Third, affirm the benefits of change. My question to you today is, what one action will you take in the next few days to get out of your comfort zone? Thank you for watching this video. Remember to touch the like button, give it a thumbs up, and comment. I really value your opinion and will appreciate your comments. If you're new here and have not subscribed yet, do press that subscriber button so that you don't miss any of the videos that we post every week. Thank you and best wishes. Keep watching. We all need to elevate our mindset at this time.